Stop it! Sisters, and what I consider to be one of the finest places to play in America, right up here, and it's always been, as long as I remember, and that's a long time ago, a really welcoming place for rock and roll and rock fans. Thank you so much for coming tonight. So ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, Uncle Glenn has been living amongst you for 43 years. And you may say, well, why haven't you been over here to see us before? That's a long, long story. Let's just say I don't remember the 1980s. And when I came out of the when I came out of the 1980s, something happened wonderful where I had something happen where I was overseas a lot. So it's important for you to know that this country is my home. I've been living here 43 years and now becoming an American citizen this fall. So I said that. Listen, if you go on YouTube, I say that every night just simply because I absolutely adore this country. It's the greatest country in the world. I know we're having problems. You know something? We got to stick together because music, people, music is the healer and will heal all in the very end. Trust me when I tell you. We're going to go back a little bit. Not that far. I'm used to the 80s, where I don't remember, of course. Brother, we have the same thing here. I have a new knee and you have a new knee, right? How was your thing? Was it okay? My thing was okay too.
Mine's
back. Anybody having things done, it's all gonna be okay. So I had a record out with Pat Thrall in 1982. So honored to be here. You've got to try and visualize how important this is for me. This is my very, very first ever solo tour of the country that I am now becoming a citizen of. And I thank you so much for showing up tonight. It means so much. Bless you all as you trudge along the happy road of destiny.
Thank you. You're not to blame.
when you touch me. You feel
I see a Tommy Boland t-shirt, I have to stop.
Yeah!
I have to, anywhere in the world, like if I can see in the audience, which I, thank you so much, Michael. I love you so much. Why am I speaking English when I'm actually, can I be American in a minute? Ah, that dock is bloody awful. So thank you. When I see one of my brothers, who I dearly, dearly loved and cherished so much,
So I'm going to celebrate Tommy tonight as we celebrate all those people that are not with us. And I will continue to do that. And if I'm the last man standing, I'll try to do the best I can. So let's talk about being honored this year in the Hall of Fame. I want to thank the people who voted for us. That's really, if you did, or you didn't, if you voted for rock bands or rock bands, that's where I'm at. You know, this has been a life that's been freely given to me, and I, for God's sake, I just want to continue to carry the message of love and music throughout this planet in which we live. And I, again, thank you for coming this evening. It means so much to me. Thank you. In memory of John Lord, this is Stormbringer.
Yeah.
Thank you so much. How are you, man? See ya. Thank you. Thank you so much for wearing that shirt. Thank you so much. It means so much to me when I see young folks wearing stuff that I've been on. And thank you for carrying the message, my friend. Thank you for carrying the message. So let's talk about a message. When I was 17, you could get a visual if you wish. It was all hair and legs back in the day. I was a man, not a boy, not a girl. I was in my grandmother's kitchen and I was starting to write music at a tender age of 16. And by the time I had turned into 17, I wrote this next rock song, which was my first rock song that was published for me back in the day. The band that recorded that song was Trapeze. May you rest in peace, Brother Mel Galley. I love you so much. This song was recorded by Trapeze and Black Country Communion. I know, I love that band too. There's gonna be more of that. Honored to be here, honored to sing for you. I'm all yours. Here we go.
Yeah.
No time to find the time. I've done what has to be done. I've done what has to be done.
I could have sworn somebody said, Glenn, your mother says you're an icon. But I think it was something sort of like that, but it sounded like icon or mother, but it wasn't that either. I shan't say what the young man said. Rather naughty. So here we are, and I'm looking at the list. This is a song I recorded in Los Angeles about 10 years ago. With my best friend Chad Smith from the Peppers, and we did. Yeah, life is so good. You just gotta grab hold of it and take it one second at a time. Let it breathe, let it ride. Let it howl. How do you feel, Sellersville? Let me hear your voices. this week again. And my soul is on the air. Won't somebody heal my pain? There is a storm inside me.
You're
Thank you so much. Thank you, thank you, thank you. No, I've never swallowed a pick. But I thought about it just right before I put the water in my mouth. I've got a pick in your mouth, Glenn. Be careful. You know, being as I'm only 43. You know, the movie Nick Cage was drinking the vodka. What was it, Leaving Las Vegas? Every time I drink this water, I know maybe one of you, just one of you, are thinking, that's not water, that's vodka, that's Mr. Hughes, he's a naughty boy. Yes, he's naughty, all right.
Not anymore.
I am the man, I also am the woman.
Excuse me?
Is he behind me again? Is he ruining my show? What's all this then?
It's so awesome. Thank you.
Woo! Okay, everybody. Thank you. This is a song I did write. I wrote this with David Coverdale. And the truth of the matter is, David and I wrote this to go on the album called called Burn, and let's just say that it didn't make it onto the Burn or Stormbringer. Not naming names. Because I love all of the gentlemen in that band, still do to this very day. My family. So this ended up on an album called Come Taste the Band. And again, I say to you, so very honored to be here tonight. Thank you for loving music, showing up every show that comes here. You show up, you keep rock music alive. Thank you for my life. Thank you for a life that has been freely given to me that can be taken away just like that. Keep coming back. God bless you all.
Thank you.
Yes, thank you. No, no, thank you. I said, girl, keep on moving, oh yeah, far away, oh yeah, far away. I'm talking to you.
Thank you. she is. God bless America. The land is the free.
Glad to live amongst you in the greatest country in the world. Honored to be here tonight. God bless you. Thank you for saving rock and roll. Peace, brothers and sisters. See you again. God bless you all. Thank you. You're very kind. You're very kind. Just before we start, I made a new album, which I haven't done for 8 years until this year. It's coming in November. So it's the first Glenn album. And I want to say again that music is the healer. Just remember when you had a tough day, just go home, close the blinds, and put your headphones on and listen to your favorite music, because we can all help each other through music. Music is the universal language. It really is. And long may it all live, and long may we continue on this road of happy destiny. God bless you all. Love you to pieces.
It's all in my blood.
you for showing up tonight. It means the whole world to me and my family. Thank you. I want to introduce you to these young men on stage with me. These fellas have been with me before Black Country Communion. I had to take a break and I've come back. Please welcome from Gothenburg on drums. He's a big, really tall Swedish dude. Say hi to Pontus Engborg, one of the greatest drummers in the world today. There's only three guys up here. There's nobody behind the curtain. And on the guitar, my beautiful guitar player from Copenhagen, Denmark, Mr. Søren Andersen. Not too bad to look at either. God bless America. God bless all of you people here tonight. It means so much to come home to the country I live in and play here for you. And I am so blessed. And God bless you all. Thank you so very much. Stay close to one another, people. Stay free. Stay free. We love you. God bless.